name is Robert William Snodgrass, born Walton, West Virginia, 18 October 1919. I don't know if anybody would ever be interested in all this stuff, but just in case my grandchildren or somebody down the road might want to know what their grandpa did, I'll just kind of brief you, give you a skimmer over everything and see how you appreciate it. After I graduated from high school in 1938, there wasn't hardly any work in the country at that time. It was very, very hard to get a job of any kind. So I decided that I'd better see if I could get in the Navy. So I went down to Charleston, West Virginia, and went to the recruiting officer at the post office building. It didn't do any good there, so I talked to my uncle. He was a postmaster in Charleston at that time. And since the recruiting boys were in the post office building, he knew them all. So he talked to them. He called me and said they decided to give me a physical, and if I could pass the physical, they'd get me in the Navy. So a few days later, I got a note, and they sent me down to Richmond, Virginia for a physical, and I passed that. So they took me into the Navy. That was that was the 10th of October, 1938, when I took the oath. They sent me down to Norfolk to boot camp. I had 13 weeks of boot camp. And after boot camp, I got a small leave to go home. I think it was 14 days, got to go home. Visit the family, see people on the farm. I was strutting around my Navy uniform. I thought I was hot stuff with that Navy uniform on. So after my time was up there and at home, I went back to Norfolk, reported in, and they assigned me to a ship, the USS Chalmont. She was one of the last coal burners in the Navy. So we shipped out of Norfolk and went down to Culebra. And down at Culebra, they transferred me off to and put me aboard the USS Raleigh, the old Omaha-class cruiser, four-piper. And we did fleet maneuvers down there. The entire Atlantic fleet was down there doing maneuvers. After that was over, we went into Guantanamo Bay, and I took a train into Havana, Cuba, and we left there. We went down to Dominican Republic, Ciudad Trujillo, made delivery there, and then we went around to Gonaives, Haiti. That's on the same island, Isla Hispania. And got orders to head north, and we started to go up to the World's Fair in New York. So we stopped in Richmond, Virginia, and we got orders to head back to Pacific. I guess the Pan A got sunk over the Yangtze River, and it's afraid we might have some problems with the Chinese, so they sent several ships back through the ditch to the canal, go back into the Pacific side of the country. So we took on ammunition and fuel there in Richmond, went back down, went through the ditch. On the way up to Frisco, we stopped in San Diego, made delivery there, went ashore and visited, went down to Tijuana and all that good stuff, went delivery there in San Diego. Got up to San Francisco, and we anchored out in the harbor, and we'd take a water taxi to go into see the World's Exposition there on Treasure Island. They had a lot of expositions there, but the one I liked most was Sally Rand's Nude Ranch. Little old 19-year-old country boy out there seeing all those naked girls. It was really something for me. So eventually they told us they were going to ship us to the Hawaiian Islands, we became the Hawaiian Detachment. We had the Admiral Award, and he was Comm Des Flot 1. That's Commander Des Destroyer Flotilla. And we had the band aboard and everything. You know, we had all accommodations for the Admiral aboard. Cruised around the islands and had good liberty in Honolulu. We went out for gunnery practice. We practiced with the 6-inch. We practiced with the 3-inch anti-aircraft battery. And we practiced with our 50-caliber machine guns, our 1.1 AK-AK gun. That was an old British gun, the 1.1. We practiced, had torpedo practice. We had our planes go up. We had Kingfishers aboard. We had 2 planes aboard for catapults. And we send them up to Toast Leaves. We paint the shells we paint the shells different colors for different guns, so you know which gun hit the sleeve. When it got the sleeve back down, we checked the paint marks on it and see which gun was more accurate. On the 6th of December, I went ashore. Didn't get back till about midnight. Yeah, got up about 7:30 the next morning. Went down below deck, having a grapefruit. All at once, a big explosion. The ship just lifted up out of the water. I thought a magazine blew up forward or something like that. Into what world happened? What happened though? We had a torpedo hit right across. It's halfway between the quarter deck and the bow. Knocked a big hole inside the ship. We sat down. We didn't know what happened. We thought the magazine blew up or something like that. Started running up topside because we started listed right away. Some guy was running down in front of the midship hatch saying, "Get below, they're bombing us." I said, "Who's bombing us?" He said, "I don't know." He said, "But said, they're sure bombing us." So I got up topside and several guys up there were manning the guns. We had awnings up over the guns. They was up with the wire cables. We got the galleys right next to them. We got the meat cleavers out of the galley and cut those cables. Got the awnings down from over the guns and got the plugs out of the barrels. Trained them out. We tried to get the ready box. The ready box was full of ammunition because we were supposed to go out Monday morning for gunnery practice. And the ready box was all locked. Had big locks on them, so we took meat cleavers and beat the locks off, got our shells out, and got to firing right away.